Well, it's all but certain that the issue of federal officers in Portland and other cities will be a topic of discussion on Capitol Hill when Attorney General William Barr testifies before the House Judiciary Committee on Tuesday. This past week, Barr said some of the reactions to the death of George Floyd were, quote, extreme. That comment came at the same event where President Trump said he will be sending more federal law enforcement officers to certain cities. And that brings me to your weekend presidential brief with CNN national security analyst and my good friend, Sam Vinograd. Great to see you, Sam. She's here to break down the most pressing national security issues facing the U.S., and she's helped prepare the daily presidential brief for President Obama. Sam, let me ask you, there are many topics that could come up during this Barr testimony, a lot of questions people have for him. What are you going to be looking for specifically?
Well, Bianca, the Department of Justice is billing this hearing as a general oversight testimony by the Attorney General. But that's selling the intent of the hearing woefully short. We need to remember that Chairman Nadler has not taken impeaching Bill Barr off the table based on Barr's alleged politicization of the Department of Justice. We should expect the chairman to question Bill Barr about a litany of alleged abuses, including Barr's role in the dismissal of charges against Michael Flynn, the Stone sentencing debacle, the events that unfolded in Lafayette Park against peaceful protesters, and more. And this is one of the scariest things I've ever said on television, Bianca, but we can't trust the attorney general to be honest. Time and time again, he has proven that he is more focused on placating POTUS than he is about actually representing reality. We saw that with his mischaracterization of the Mueller report's findings, his mischaracterization of the role of Antifa in fomenting violence at protests and other incidents. And for that reason, while oversight is a core tenet of democracy, from a global perspective, this testimony may do more harm than good. If Bill Barr continues to misrepresent reality, it is likely that he will further undermine the credibility of our institutions. That's a major win for people like Putin.
That is true. And today, speaking of Putin, today marks 100 days until the 2020 election, and it looks like deja vu. The election security outlook now in question. We have intelligence officials who issued a warning Friday that China, Russia, and Iran were expanding their influence effort. Was that warning urgent enough? Because I do recall that it was also a Friday when there was a warning that came out in 2016 from intelligence officials that basically fell on deaf ears.
Well, the key takeaway from this intelligence warning is that Donald Trump has failed. Donald Trump has failed to deter threats to our elections. China and Iran were not listed as threats to our 2016 election. So either our intelligence has gotten better or other actors, namely China and Iran, decided to join the fray when it comes to attacking our elections based on Donald Trump's open door policy to Putin's attacks on our democracy. Now, it's notable that this statement from the intelligence community has come under criticism. Democrats have claimed that this statement really painted a false equivalency between the efforts of China, Russia, and Iran. These nation states differ significantly in terms of the scope, scale, and tactics they are using to attack our elections. You cannot compare the scale of China's attacks against our elections with those of Russia. And finally, this statement is so vague, Bianca. Mm-hmm. It doesn't, for example, indicate which candidate these countries prefer. And it really begs the question of why this administration is either misinforming us or underinforming us when it is so critical that the public has as much information as possible.
And we also know the president recently spoke with Vladimir Putin, and from their readouts, this wasn't brought up, that the bounties on U.S. soldiers wasn't brought up as well. So a lot of unanswered questions, but I agree with you. These are very urgent issues. Samantha Vinograd, thanks for joining us. Great to see you.
Good to see you.
Have a great weekend.